people all over the world, in the countries I've been going to, in Africa, in Europe, and here in America, I see wherever a baby is born, I mean, it's a lot of joy in families. In Africa, it's all the same. People celebrate, people rejoice when a baby is born in the family because the tribe, the clan, the family is growing big. The same story here in America too. People rejoice, but above all, for the Americans, I congratulate you upon the faith you have, because when I came to America, I was shocked to see when people give gifts to the baby who is not yet born, what you call a baby shower. In Africa, it's hard people do that. And even when the mother is in labor, others people, they just jump with their clothes, they rush her to the hospital. Then after having delivering, then they bring the cloth the baby needs in the hospital. Because they say, who knows, if you bring the cloth in the hospital and the baby is born, maybe not alive. So people have those kind of doubts. But in America, faith is just strong. The baby is coming, no doubt. Now, at the church today, we are also happy to celebrate the new life William is going to embrace. The new life William is going to begin in his life. By the virtue of the sacrament of baptism, he's going to get today, as we had the first reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, none of us lives for himself or for herself. Once we are baptized, we live for Christ. So from today onwards, William is going to live for Christ, to witness the holy name of Jesus, to witness the gospel of love, of peace, and justice. And as all of us, I would ask you to direct your eyes to William, and you see how he has already begun to witness the gospel by the life of humility, by the life of being, the life of trust, knowing that even though I may be young, not knowing what's going around my life, my mom is there. What can you do to William without the consent of Michaela here? What can you do to William without the consent of Alan, the dad, the grandmas, the grandpas, the friends? William is all protected. Life of humility and trust. So that's what again today is teaching all of us. To be humble and full of trust in our Lord Jesus Christ, in our God, that whatever may be happening around our lives, we know God our Father is there protecting us. So as William is getting baptized today, as we had in the Gospel, when Jesus himself was baptized in the Jordan, the voice came from heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son, my favor rests on him, or on you." These are the very ones God is going to speak to Abraham. My beloved son, my beloved child, my favor rests on you. For William to be a wonderful child of God all through his life, he needs support from each one of us. Dear godparents, you really have the responsibility to support William, that all through his life he may be a wonderful son of God, always humble, trusting, and doing the will of the Father. As a godparent, your responsibility to see that William prays. Whenever we have a time, Paul, Mikhail, and Alan say, "Did William have evening prayers today? Did he have time to go to church? Is he fulfilling his fundamental practices of the Catholic faith?" To see that, as he's going to receive the light, and say that he's a child of light, no longer a child of darkness, that light is kept lit. So it's a responsibility as godparents to support the parents to see all the fundamentals of the faith we are going to baptize William into are kept in his life. For the parents, Mikhail and Alan, the environment you're going to give to William is important for him to grow in faith, to grow in love, to grow in true knowledge of God. You too, the respect you have for one another, the love you have for one another, is very important. Provide a wonderful environment to favor William to grow in that spirit God wants his son to grow into, a life of love. As we baptize him, the Holy Spirit will come upon him. So we pray that the Holy Spirit may be active in the life of William, to lead him, to strengthen him, to let the will of the Father be effected in his life. So I'd ask you as parents and godparents to come forward, that may go ahead with the ritual during the sacrament of baptism. Please come forward. William, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. William, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment the outward sign of your Christian dignity. With your family and friends, help you by one example, bring that dignity and strength into the everlasting life of heaven. Receive the light of Christ, parents and godparents. This light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. He is to walk always as a child of the light. May he keep a flame of faith alive in his heart. When the Lord comes, may he go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavens.